So then, this episode doesn't need an introduction of what I'm saying, so I'll just let you hear me talk about this. Let's get on with it. Rowan Atkinson, he's a man of pure comedy. You may know him for appearing in things such as Blackadder, the Johnny English movies, and you guessed it, Mr. Bean. The man with a rather idiotic and childish character, Mr. Bean is quite certainly one of the most funniest characters in television. It revolves around Bean going to places and solving various problems, having some rather disastrous and hilarious results. He has a teddy bear named Teddy, a 1977 British Leyland Mini, and a girlfriend named Irma Gobb. The show ran for about 15 episodes from 1990 to 1995 and would be regarded as one of the most iconic sitcoms in the UK. The popularity of a character, Mr. Bean, would later spawn two movies, an animated series, and appearing in several things, especially during the London 2012 Olympics opening ceremony. And on top of a character, from 2004 to 2007, a set of DVDs were released, having some episodes in each volume. The ones I remember having were the second, third, fourth, and fifth volumes. I sadly did not get the first volume, although there was this DVD, which seems to be from the US, as it doesn't have a BBFC rating on it. This DVD was the closest to being the first of the volumes, despite the fact that some of the episodes included on the DVD were already on the ones I got. But on the plus side, at least I got to experience the first and last episodes of the show, so that's a neat experience for me. Anyway, the fourth volume is what I'm going to be talking about. Without much explanation, let's get on with the show. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any footage of that DVD anywhere, as it mostly has videos of the other Volume 4 of the Mr. Bean DVD. So, I'll just tell you what content there is on the disc. The first episode on the DVD is Do It Yourself, Mr. Bean. This episode, much like the others in the show, has scenes divided into several acts, with this one having only three. The plot of the episode is that it takes place during New Year's Eve of 1993 and Mr. Bean is getting ready for the New Year. For his New Year party, he invited two of his friends and has very few decorations set up. Just when Bean prepares for refreshments, he picks up a can of Twiglets and eats the last one of them, not having any left. So, he gets a branch from a tree outside and chops it into twigs. And with no champagne left, he uses a bottle of vinegar and adds some sugar to sweeten it. Ew. Bean's two friends do not like the so-called food he set up, but Bean just consumes his own food anyway, not caring about it. The two friends, yes, I know they're called Rupert and Hubert in this episode, but I don't have time to call their names, then turn the clock to midnight, tricking Mr. Bean that the new year has arrived. They then pretend that they are tired and say goodbye to him. Later, when Bean falls asleep in his bed, he hears people at the party doing the countdown process and soon, the year 1994 arrives. This angered Mr. Bean as his friends had tricked him by setting the clock to midnight earlier. The second act has Mr. Bean driving to a department store on New Year's Day. Fun fact, the store scene in the episode is called Arding and Hobbs, and since June 2020, it has remained closed. Bean goes to the store in front of a queue as there's a January sale there. He bought several things, like the armchair seen on the display of the window. His items were too big to fit inside his car, so he puts his armchair on top of a car, uses ropes to operate the steering wheel, and a broom to operate the pedals. He sets off with his car, and everything seems all right with Bean, just until he diverts into a steep hill and breaks the room while trying to hit the brakes, making him stop and crash into a lorry filled with mattresses. The third act has Mr. Bean redecorating his house with the items he bought. There are a lot of shenanigans Bean is ensuing, like dropping items on the floor without even looking or realizing, and then using a reciprocating saw to fill a hole from the wall. His next step was to paint the entire living room. His paintbrush was very old and dry, so he used his own teddy bear to paint the walls. How unwilling was that for the bear? After accidentally putting some drips on some things, Bean decides to do the most dangerous and unethical way to paint the room, placing a firecracker in the white paint can to make everything in the room white. How is something like that even possible in real life? The firecracker explodes, but before that, one of Bean's friends, Hubert, goes back into Bean's flat to look for his hat, and when he gets it, he gets covered in white paint off-screen, leaving a silhouette of him on the wall as the unpainted area of the living room. How's that a way to end off the episode? A quite entertaining episode from Mr. Bean, as it takes place during New Year's Eve and at the end of 1993 and the beginning of 1994, as it says. This episode was also iconic for the scene where Mr. Bean drives his car on top of a roof by sitting in his armchair, and would later be recreated in later events, played by Rowan Atkinson, reprising his role as Mr. Bean himself. There's also this leitmotif that's played throughout the episode, and I don't know if people will recreate it, as it sounds very memorable. But overall, it's a very funny episode, especially one that takes place during the new year. The next episode after that is Back to School, Mr. Bean. This episode has four acts in between. This episode is about Mr. Bean attending an open day at a local school. There's a Mini that's identical to his own car, and two army cadets help Bean to push it away. There's also Bean commanding a troop of cadets to do nonsensical stances, and the commander angrily yells at them for acting so silly and... yeah, you know that I'm not gonna let the sound play for itself, as I've got... you know... Bean gets inside of the school and looks at various things on the wall and harassing some people. More hijinxes are involved as Bean uses a Van de Graaff generator to make his hair stand on end, but does nothing. However, his hand gets stuck to a leaflet when he picks it up and tries to remove it, ultimately giving it to a woman and... yeah... The second act has Mr. Bean going into a chemistry lab and tampering around several chemicals until he creates a chemical reaction, causing an explosion just as he exits the lab. He then goes into a still life art class and is instructed by the teacher to draw a bowl of fruit, but is then replaced by... yup, you can clearly tell that some jokes are pretty much aimed towards adults here. Bean then covers the topless woman with clay pots so that he can draw her without seeing her... naked. The third act has Bean partaking in a judo class, and he is scared to be thrown by the instructor, and by pure instinct, he later overtakes the instructor by rolling him up in a mat. Quite funny. As he changed back to his regular clothes, he finds out that someone else is wearing his trousers. He searches for them and sees that the man in the men's toilet is wearing them. He luckily gets them back and also accidentally throws the man's underpants in the toilet. Clearly a clumsy man he is. The fourth act has been returning to his Mini, but stops to buy a cupcake at a cake stall. And unaware of this, his car gets crushed by a tank in the middle of a demonstration. Bean looks in horror at his destroyed car, just as the credits roll, having a somber variation of a theme song. However, near the end, he finds that the padlock he used to lock his Mini has not been broken up, feeling rather joyed. So, that was what this episode was about, Mr. Bean going to a school to attend an open day and causing havoc in various classes he visits. There are a few jokes that hit very hard, and the end of a fourth act has the mini being destroyed by a tank. Though two episodes later in the episode Good Night, Mr. Bean, it's shown that Mr. Bean has another car, having the same appearance as the previous one. As it's implied that Bean may have gotten another car of the same build as his previous one. So all in all, it's quite a decent episode. Especially if that one scene with a commander yelling scared me as of now, despite that it didn't when I was a kid. The third and last episode on the DVD is Tee Off, Mr. Bean, only having two acts around this time. The first act has Mr. Bean going to the laundrette to clean several things, most of which are objects such as a welcome mat, two fuzzy dices, and even Teddy. Bean also puts his underpants being labelled in which day of the week he wore them into the washing machine and then realises that he's forgotten the underpants he wore on Wednesday and assumes the current day is Wednesday and that he is wearing one. Just as he removes his trousers get mixed up by a lady's skirt. Bean then wears the skirt by mistake and sees the underwear on the floor, realizing that the missing one is actually Sundays and not Wednesdays. He attempts to stop the washing machine to get his Wednesday underwear back, but the machine has already been turned on and the black belt thug torments Bean for fun. Bean then has had enough of a bully and decides to pay him back. His plan is that he replaced the thug softener with a cup of black coffee. It works, and the thug doesn't realize that he poured coffee into the washing machine, having his clothes completely stained. After paying the bully out, Bean retrieves his mutated washing out, where one had Teddy Bean completely shrunken. He then tries to get his trousers back from the lady's washing by climbing into the dryer. And with the lady having her headphones on, she doesn't notice that Bean is inside and turns the machine on, causing poor Bean to spin around. And I'm just gonna let Sonic give off this advice.
Believe it or not, every year some ignorant kid takes a ride in a clothes dryer just like this one, and ends up getting hurt. It gets pretty hot in there, and those dryer fins can break your bones when they get going. If you think it's smart to climb in a dryer, you're really all wet.
Well said, Sonic. The second act has Mr. Bean going to a golf course to play mini golf. He scores a hole-in-one on the first hole, but in the second, it's complete mayhem. By being forbidden to pick up the ball with his own hands, Bean hits it outside the course, going through a chaotic journey through several places when he hits the ball. From a bus, to a lady's shopping bag, to a boy's ice cream cone, to an exhaust pipe of a car, to down the drain, to a litter bin, to a rubbish lorry, to finally landing on the grass. Bean then tries to hitchhike back to the golf course, and the first car that appears is the ever so famous Reliant Regal that has been constantly used as a punching bag in the series. The second car is where Bean gets into and cuts out the turf that the golf ball is on and orders the driver to drive him back to the golf course. Just as the ending credits roll, Bean makes it back to the course just as it was about to close. He finally rolls the ball into the second hole, leaving a score of 3,427 strokes. Wow. While the first act is mostly about Mr. Bean having some antics at the laundrette, the second act is what I liked most, as it's got a lot of energy and chaos going around as Bean hits the golf ball with his club around several places, making a lot of trouble. It's an episode filled with haywire as a man does some shenanigans with a golf ball, and it never fails to make anyone laugh. But despite those being the only episodes from the live-action series, there's some bonus content included on the DVD, one of which is an episode from the animated series. If you're already aware or not, there's an animated series of Mr. Bean that first aired back in 2002 and was running all the way up until 2019, with a total of 5 seasons spanning over 130 episodes. The cartoon sees Mr. Bean going around some adventures and adding new characters, like Mrs. Wicket, who is Mr. Bean's grouchy landlady, and her cat named Scrapper. The cartoon had a style that made the characters look distinctive in their own way, especially Bean and Irma, who were characters from the live-action series. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the episode from the animated series that was included as a bonus on the DVD is called Treasure. It revolves around Bean finding a jigsaw puzzle and discovering that the last piece is missing. He finds a map that leads him to a treasure inside a tree, which contained a map. And this was the joke I didn't understand as a kid. So apparently, Bean sees that he must fly to somewhere else because there's treasure and he gets on the plane. But when the plane takes off, he looks out the window and starts to freak out and pretends to be sick to get off the plane. I didn't understand what that was about when I watched this episode over and over again. But just when I recently rewatched this episode for this video, I looked at the comments where it said that the joke was that the map that Bean found was shaped like Australia and he had to fly over there. However, just when he was on the plane, he looked out of a window and is shocked to realize that a park on a small island is shaped exactly like the land down under. It's a pretty neat visual gag as done by the animators for sure, as I didn't know what it meant when I was a kid. So, later in the episode, Bean finds out that the treasure has a key inside the chest, and it's the key to the case that has the last piece of a puzzle all along. That was what the premise of the episode's about, and it's quite charming too. This also applied to some of the other Mr. Bean DVDs, as they've got episodes of the animated series as bonus content. And it's very funny as the kid-friendly cartoon contrasted to the more adultish jokes seen in the live-action on some of the DVDs. But anyway, that's all I have to say about this episode from the cartoon. So, with 3 of the episodes from the Mr. Bean series and a bonus one from the cartoon, how well does this DVD fare? To be precise, it shows Bean going into some antics like redecorating his house on New Year, attending open day at school and causing trouble in classes, and doing some madness while playing mini-golf. Out of the 3 episodes, I think I like do-it-yourself Mr. Bean more, as it has Mr. Bean driving his car on top of a rooftop while sitting in his armchair and the leitmotif that plays throughout the episode. Rowan Atkinson may indeed be one of the best comedians in the UK, as he's up there with Eric Idle, Harry Hill, and John Cleese. And he's had his recent outing with the Netflix film Man vs. Bee, and his nonsensical and hilarious performances will never die. And what exactly is the next episode going to be about, you may ask? Well, we're going back with Thomas again, and this time, I'll be diving into a VHS tape that has episodes from the first season, showing me what episodes there were during the Blue Tank Engine's early years. And I hope to tell you the history of when I came around this tape, so until then, toodaloo!